Welcome back to seg6 TV. We're here with hip-hop artist Andrew. He also does rap.
Hip-hop and rap, yes.
Yes, Andrew. So tell me a little bit about your music. And I know it's not easy in this industry. Tell me a little bit about your music.
Well, my music is just, you know, it's just what I love doing. It's my passion. Every day, going through what I go to, all I know is music. Now, I'm not gonna lie to y'all. Thousands of dollars in this music stuff. I sleep on the streets. I come to this festival 5 in the morning, don't leave till it's over. I do what I gotta do because there is no love in this music industry. Would y'all rather sleep at a hotel for a few days just to get some rest, or would you rather sleep at a fast food restaurant or the corner store and hit the studio and shoot music videos to further your career and hope and know that something's gonna give out of it? Because you're right, man, nothing is easy in this music industry. I've been here since 7 this morning, caught 3 buses from Fort Lauderdale from Broward County, y'all, and I pray every day. I'm only 18 years old. You know how they did Jaw Wrong and XXX for y'all that don't know.
Right.
We're in the same foster care, man, and when you turn 18, the government does not show love, and sometimes you got to keep on pushing even though no one's there.
So the grind is real with you. So in your music, you have a lot of experiences that you pour into it, and so there's a lot of people that sometimes they get discouraged because of the obstacles, and to be so young and to be experience certain things, you might get discouraged and you might stray away from your dreams and your goals. How do you promote the energy that you have? What is it that you do to motivate people, and how do you keep going on with those experiences?
Well, to be honest with you, the only reason I keep on going is, even though I may not have nothing to lose, I think about life and itself, and I think about coming out here today. You know, I come out here hyped up because I'm not trying to show off. I'm just trying to do what I have to do. Now, like, at the end of the day, you know, in this music industry, there's no love. But as long as I know I'm feeling good about it, that's all that matters. And, you know, I'm going to keep on going hard every day. I'm going to do what I have to do. I'm about to do another music video tomorrow, and I'm going to keep on doing it. I'm going to go broke eating out of a peanut butter jar. Like, it's not easy, man. It's really not easy out here.
Love it, love it, love it. So you talked about XXX. And you knew him personally?
Well, yeah, I kind of knew him. We were in the same foster care when we were younger together.
Okay.
And now doing that and having that to be done, man, it's kind of sad because, like, going through foster care, going through adoption, going through all these obstacles, being kicked out when you're 18 on these streets, and seeing what you see and all this depression because you feel like no one's there.
Right.
Well, yeah, why do you think Extra's a little upset? Why do you think Jaw's a little upset? Because y'all don't understand how people treat us, how people do us. You know, it may be all good in front of y'all, but behind closed doors, y'all don't know what's happening.
So what is it that people could do to better the situation?
I feel like you should hear us out and understand what we're going through. Because after this show tonight, some of y'all may go home to a big mansion. I mean, myself and I, I'm gonna just go back to Checkers tonight, lay my head at the restaurant, and, you know, propel and maintain from this obstacle, you know, and just hope I can keep it pushing, you know, and do what's best for me.
Love it, love it. All right, so in your experiences, you said that you're gonna go back to a Checkers?
Yeah, tonight, I'm supposed to get my appointment next week.
Okay.
I got a little job. I only started out when I got kicked out from foster care when I was 18. I only started off with $350. I worked at McDonald's. They treated me horrible over there. I didn't like it, you know?
Okay.
I quit doing my music back to back, racked up about a band and a half. Right now, I'm sitting on $900 in the bank account, and I'm not scared to say it. You know, I'm going to do what I have to do.
But so you make no excuses?
No excuses. There's no excuses to do this. Like, oh, yeah, you have to put money into this as well. So, like it's not going to be easy, you know? And
so the advice you give to somebody, in a nutshell, grind.
Because you should always keep on going. You know why? Because they say trust the process. But even though sometimes I may not want to trust the process, I think about maybe because, you know, God's waiting for a spot to open up for me. And I pray every day. I get on my knees and ask God, why? Why do I have to keep on going through all this just to get to somewhere? I didn't even know this festival was today. I couldn't perform, you know why? Because I didn't have a cell phone with service to attach to the Wi-Fi to get on Instagram.
But you're here.
But I'm here. And you know what?
Divine intervention. You see that? You see how the universe work? You see how the universe work? So what can we contact you for more information? What can we contact you?
Contact me at Andrew B. Ballin. AndrewBewBallin. And one thing I want to tell y'all, have faith. Have faith, man. That's one thing I'm going to tell y'all.
Say it, we'll keep contacting you again so they can hear you.
AndreWBeBallin. Andrew B. Ballin, all lowercase. And like I told y'all, man, there's only one thing you have, really. And that's God, man. Lil Drew, Andrew B. Ballin. Please show some love.
Thanks for saying you got to check Andrew out, you guys. A lot of drive, a lot of heart. Check him out.
Already.